I'm having a bit of a rough night, and I thought it'd be an opportunity to just make a little video. Because then I started to think how many other mothers are and fathers are crying in bed right now. I think it's, especially hard for single mothers because they don't have that. They don't have a father to lean on. I just wanted to say that it's okay to hurt. It's okay to cry. It's okay to be heartbroken. It's okay to take your time with grieving. But night times are the hardest because you have all the time in the world to think. And I started thinking about, having to leave Milo on his own. And I know at the end of the day I had to. It might seem really like morbid to people who have lost a child, but when you think about you, I had to leave my child in the hospital, and every time I think about that, there's just something in me that says, go and get him then, But you just can't, and it's so suffocating. Like sometimes it just hits you. Like it was yesterday, because sometimes I forget. I don't know what it is, sometimes I just forget that Milo really isn't coming back. And when it hits me that he's actually in the ground and there's no going back, sometimes you really forget that they're gone forever. Like I involve Milo in my days as much as I can. I try and incorporate him into the things that I do as much as I can, and that makes me feel good. And then when it comes to the night time, not all the time, but sometimes you realise that you're just never gonna see them again. And it's just like your heart's just ripped out again. And it's hard because you can put such a front on in the daytime. And people are happy to see you that way. And they think that, you're moving on. But it's all a mask. I've met some wonderful women since losing Milo, although in the really unfortunate circumstances that I've met these women. Just think how many women are in the same position as me where you don't have anyone to lean on and you're crying yourself to sleep most nights. It's hard. And then tonight I just started thinking how many other women are or single fathers, just crying themselves to sleep. Tomorrow and I'll wake up and I'll be fine. Not fine. I just put my mask back on. And I get through the day, like, as much as I can involve Milo in my day, the easier the day is. But then nights like this, it just hits you like a ton of bricks. So maybe I'll start vlogging more. You know, times like this where I feel I need to say something. But I guess that thing is that you're doing so well. Like, I think grieving parents don't realise how strong they are, because half the time I'm thinking, why am I still here? My son isn't here, so what am I doing? What am I still doing? What am I doing here? And I think that makes me realise how strong I am and how strong the parents are as well, who've lost their children. So I just want to say, if you're struggling, it's okay. You know, look after yourself, put yourself first. It's okay to grieve. Take as long as you need. Don't let anybody rush you into moving on. Because when it comes to grieving a child, it goes on for a lifetime, and I realised that from when I was told that Milo had passed away. I just miss him so much, but I'm just so proud of him. So yeah, I'm trying to get some sleep.